Hey everyone, it's Bailey and welcome back to my channel. So today I am finally updating you guys. Well, it's not really updating, but I'm doing like my mini project pan finale. So if you've been following my project pan, you would know that I have been trying to pan a few items over the past couple of months. So I believe it's been like 3 months and like a week now. I gave myself an extra week because I was so close on certain products, but I started this back in April and now it's finally time to end it. And I also want to give y'all some thoughts on my feelings on project panning and if I'm going to do it again. So if you like project pans and like these more kind of declutter, shop my stash kind of videos, let me know by giving me a thumbs up and let's just get into it and see how I did. So we're just gonna go with order of application. So first things first, primer, and I was using the Imani Perfect 10 Priming Serum. And as you can tell, I did not finish it, but this was almost totally full when I started. It was probably up to like here where the text starts. And it's now down to about here, as you can tell. So I think that's pretty good progress, and you know, thinking about it, it is better in a way, if you want to spin it this way, that this primer, if you use it every single day, for the most part, you know, some days I didn't wear makeup, it's gonna last more than 3 months. I definitely have probably like 3 weeks left out of this, so probably, you know, it'd end up being like a 4 month product, and that's kind of nice to know because you don't want your products to go like super fast, right? So really like not the best start to my project pan, but I tried and I got pretty far. Now for the foundation that I was using, this is the Dr. Jart Premium BB Cream. This one I wasn't thinking when I threw this in here because I can't tell how far I am with the product because you can't like squeeze it or anything, but I will let y'all know that it has been one of those products that I have to kind of give it a good shake to get product out now, so that is a good sign. Maybe I can open it up and see. Yeah, there's still some product definitely in there, but I want to say it did pretty good. Now, was I using this as often as I was using my primer? No, just because I got so freaking bored, but I did use a lot of this and I am having to kind of like do this number whenever I'm using it now, so made some progress, but we didn't finish it. Okay, now for concealer, these were a little bit better. So first I have the Neutrogena Hydro Boost. I did not finish this one either, but I got so freaking close. This is how much I have left, y'all. Just like a little bit, probably another month's use. But I don't only use this when I felt like my under eyes were dry, which, you know, for about like 2 months, they really haven't been. But the past couple weeks, they've been a little bit more dry. So I've been using this a little bit more recently, but I made pretty good headway. And then the other one is my Neutrogena Instant Age Rewind Dark Circle Eraser. And this one's basically totally gone. There's like the teeniest little sliver of product, but I'm gonna consider this an empty because I'm tired of using it. I just need like new stuff in my life, so I think this is a win. Now for face powder, I was using up the Cover FX Perfect Setting Powder, and this was like, I am so freaking close. It's literally like right here. Like right here, I'm so close. I'll probably finish it up within the next like week. So I'm gonna consider that a win just for my own sanity because I'm literally just so close. Like, we'll just grandfather her in, you know? She won. We did it. She's empty. Okay, next is the bronzer that I wanted to hit pan on. And if you guys have been keeping up with my videos, you know, I finally did it. This is the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. And look at that pan, y'all. Yep, got a big old dent in there, so this was definitely a win. It took for freaking ever, but once I hit pan, I feel like it's going by so fast. But I've been really loving this. This is one of those products I didn't get tired of using, so that just shows how much I love it. And then for blush, kind of the biggest fail of this whole project pan. I don't even know why I included a blush, because I knew I wouldn't hit pan, because I get so bored. I like to switch things up so often, especially when it comes to blush. But I have this little sample of the Cargo Waterproof blush in the shade Bali. I'm wearing it today. I do really like this blush, but we made no progress. Even though I did use it a lot, you can definitely see it's pretty worn, but yeah, there's not like a dent or anything, so I'm gonna get a lot of use out of the sample, that's for sure. But I don't even know why I included a blush in this, because like, it was never gonna happen. All right, and for eyes, I have the Milani eyeshadow primer. Y'all, I am so close, again, being done with this. Maybe a 3 month like project pan just isn't feasible because, I mean, I wear makeup on a very regular basis. Like, realistically thinking, probably within a month, there's maybe only like 2-3 days max where I don't wear any makeup. And I always use primer. So, I mean, I can like see through the bottle. There's probably like another month's worth of product in here. I'm guessing just kind of in the bottom. But I'm so close on this, y'all. It'll be in an empty soon. I know it. And then finally, the piece de resistance of the project pan, at least I think, is the eyeshadow portion. So y'all know I've been using my Jaclyn Hill palette from Morphe. As you can tell, she is disgusting. I need to clean her off because, I mean, I've been using her. I used the palette today for my eye look, and I do really like this palette. I didn't get bored of it. I didn't use it, like, every single day because that wouldn't be feasible. Well, it would be feasible. Like, it's doable. But I have so many eyeshadow palettes and, like, new eyeshadow palettes coming out that I want to use. But I would say probably 3 days of the week I would use this palette. So, this is what she looks like. Super, super dirty. But look at all of that pan. So, I hit pan on these 3 shades right here, this highlight shade, these 2 transition shades. I hit pan on these 2 shimmer shades right here, as you can tell. And then, did I hit pan on anything else? I think that's it. But I did make some pretty good dents in some colors. Like, this one has a good dent in it. This gold has a nice dent in it. This pink, super underrated color. This one's really, really pretty. Has a nice dent in it. Started to get a dent in this one because I figured, you know, I used those enough time to use another one. So I definitely got a lot of use out of this palette. I'm going to consider this a win. I mean, 5 shades, hit pan on, and I hit some serious pan on it. So I think that's good. And I do really like this palette, so there we go. Okay, y'all, so those are all the products I included in this little mini project pan. I hope you guys liked it, and I know I didn't, like, do a check-in every month just because I didn't feel like it was necessary. I did in, like, a mid-time check-in. And I guess now the question is, would I do a project pan again? No. No, I don't really like it. Like, I think I'm good at using up my products. Like, I have a few products that are currently in my makeup bag, like an eyebrow pencil and some mascaras that are literally done. But I just don't like feeling constrained to, like, certain products. Like, I didn't like feeling like I could only really use this when I wanted to use, like, a different foundation or whatever, whatever. So I honestly don't see myself doing another project pan, but I definitely do try and use up my products, like, especially if I know I'm super close to finishing something up, I'll use it and I'll include it in my empties. And I do empties probably every like 3 months. So that's just kind of my 2 cents. I know some people love doing like year-long project pans. I think people are doing like a 13 by Halloween kind of project pan. And I'm not going to participate in that one just because I don't think it's for me. But anyways, that is everything for today's video. Hopefully y'all liked it. And yeah, that is everything. And I will see you guys next time.